What's up, everybody? My name is Life of a Doctor, also known as Dr. Fayez, and today we're going to rate the years it takes to become a doctor. Let's get to it. All right, so let's kick it off with the pre-med years. This is for me from 2011 to 2015, where I majored in biomedical sciences. Now, I'm going to show you guys a picture of when the first time I ever played doctor. Now, this is a picture from one of my friends who busted his hand open against a window. I remember I was half asleep. It was like 2 a.m. and I get a call from one of my friends and he's freaking out. He's like, yo, Jake just busted his hand open against the window. Typical Jake. And you need to get over here and fix it. So I get there and I'm looking at this man's hand and it's bleeding everywhere. So I'm like, what is going on? So I did what any pre-med student would do. I recited the Krebs cycle, which for some reason didn't work. So then I just wrapped it. But it was honestly pretty cool because that was the first time I ever saw a doctor behind my name. So during the pre-med years, you had plenty of time off. Even taking biomedical sciences and doing those 4 to 5 classes a semester, I had plenty of time to do whatever I wanted to do. You also had vacations like Christmas and Thanksgiving off, and you just didn't have a lot of responsibilities. You just needed to do well on the MCAT and hopefully get into med school. So to summarize, you took 4 to 5 classes a semester, you had to take the MCAT, you had to do extracurriculars and apply to med school. Other than that, it was a good life. I'd have to rate the pre-med years an 8 out of 10. All right, so congratulations, you got into med school and now it's your first year. It's all supposed to be happiness from here, right? I mean, look at that smile. So let me tell you something about first year. You go from the pre-med years where you're taking 4 to 5 classes a semester to taking 13 classes a semester. Not only that, but everybody is super smart. It's like you graduated top of your class and now you're struggling just to be the bottom 10. It's crazy. And not only that, but the classes that you took just seemed way more in depth than those classes that you took in undergrad. So overall, going from pre-med to M1 year is just a completely different beast. You went from taking 5 classes a semester to 13, so your workload essentially doubled. And also the classes that you took were just way more in depth. Not only that, but you're also competing with a lot of really intelligent people who were, you know, selected by a very tough process. But with all that being said, it was still really cool that, you know, you just got accepted into med school and you're like ready to become a doctor. So that part kind of makes M1 year better. Now, that does tend to wear off once you start getting into med school and you start forgetting that. So I'd give the first year of med school 7 out of 10. All right, are you guys ready for the second year of med school? This is the worst year of med school. Now, I know what you're thinking. Fayez, you already got accepted into med school and you just finished first year. Shouldn't you already be used to the heavy load? Let me tell you about a friend called Step 1. Now, the Step 1 USMLE is a national exam that every medical student takes. And this exam and how well you do on it really opens or closes doors for specialties. Now, for me personally, I spent months studying for this test and studying heavily from 12 hours a day up to 16 hours a day. I remember I would wake up at 7 a.m. and I would study until noon. Then I would go work out and eat and then study again from 3 p.m. until I passed out at 10 p.m. And then the cycle just repeated. And this went on for months. And you can tell because this is me, first year of med school, and this is me, second year of med school. Look at that beard. That's experience. So if it wasn't for this test that essentially decided what you do for the rest of your life, I would have rated this year much higher. But like I said, it spent all year studying. The stakes are really high, so you're under a lot of stress and everything's just dependent on this one test. I would rate this year a 3 out of 10. Worst year of med school, no doubt. So now let's kick it off to third year. You finally finished taking the Step 1 USMLE. You're out of the classroom and you're finally in the hospital. and this is when everything changes. So now you're in the hospital and you're doing rotations. Basically, the school will set you up with different specialties and you rotate through them every single month. And this really gives you an opportunity to see what you like and what you don't like. So this year is great, but the only problem is if you already kind of know what you want to practice and you're stuck in a rotation that you really don't enjoy, it can be really, really slow. And this will go on for 12 months. So other people enjoyed this year way more than I did, but I wasn't a big fan of it. I already knew what I wanted to do, and I just wanted to be in the hospital in the emergency department. So I would give this year a total of 6 out of 10. And now, after so long, we get to the final year of med school, which is the best year of med school, and that's fourth year. Now, in the beginning of fourth year, you still have to do audition rotations, which are essentially just 2 to 4 week interviews with programs that you're interested in. But once you get over those in the beginning, it's all smooth sailing. And so for a brief moment in time, right before you hit residency, everything just goes back to normal. You have so much time off. I went to Thailand, Iceland. I traveled so much, went to Lebanon. It was a great experience. And so by the end of fourth year, hopefully you matched into the specialty that you wanted. You got to travel, hang out with friends and family, and you're about to start residency and finally become a doctor, which seemed like a process that you started so long ago. So I would give fourth year of med school 10 out of 10. And that's it. Those are the years that it takes to become a doctor. Thank you guys for joining me and watching this YouTube video. Be sure to subscribe if you enjoyed it. More to come.